So I'm actually filming this probably about a month after actually solving the puzzle. I've just been really lazy. I actually gifted myself a camera for Christmas this year. You know, just never really had a solid video camera and really been watching a lot of vlogs over the past couple years. So figured that I would, start maybe getting into something like that, or just doing content for like some of the stuff that I do. Like, I play in a band called Rich People, and we're always trying to just put content out. We're totally independent. I'm always the guy that's behind the camera. Like, I take a lot of film photos. I was nothing crazy, just like point and shoot stuff, but I'm always the guy behind the camera. Most of the pictures on our socials, it's usually taken by me for the most part, and I've been doing that for the last few years now, probably like at least like 3 or 4 years. You could see I only won 25 cents. I really expected that. Nothing crazy. Like, that's the majority of the prizes anyways. So, I like doing puzzles anyways. So any kind of money was really like a reward. But I did end up framing the puzzle because, you might as well get your money's worth. I probably won't do it again because it was like so hard. But yeah, I'll show the framed product, I guess. As far as my strategy, I don't know if you can really tell from the video because it's all time-lapse stuff and it, I don't know if anyone's actually like paying attention to the actual pieces or like me and like some of my family members doing the puzzle itself. Some strategies that I implemented: I took all the pieces that had the same types of sides and I organized all them, and then I kind of more finely organized them by the shape. I feel like that's just like basic info, but I feel like a lot of people would just dump all the pieces on the table and then have a mess, and it, for me, that would take me so much longer because then I wouldn't know where anything was. But yeah, I did that. I just organized things like 1,000 different times. And I think that really helps because since it's such a difficult puzzle, it's really beneficial when you start to like reorganize things as you go along, because then your eyes get kind of refreshed on like different pieces, or like, you'll end up seeing stuff that you never saw before. Then you're like, oh my God, I've been looking for this for forever. So I actually, I found out about David last year. I started binging his videos. I was sick. I had just like a cold, but it lasted like probably like five days to like a week. I was just like scrolling YouTube, and first couple of videos that I saw, I was in love with. They were just like so fun, like so jam-packed full of stuff. I wasn't thought that they were like really infectious. I liked the short format stuff that was like packed full of just like quick cut stuff that was like super entertaining all the time. So I binged literally all his videos, and it really just made me think about how people consume content these days. I actually, right now for my work, I do digital marketing. A lot of times I try to keep things super to the point and just keep the main thing the main thing. That's at least the approach that I like to take, just because I sometimes don't have the craziest attention span. I know that sometimes people don't with longer vlog styles. To me, it's kind of like reading a book where it's like you don't really want to get through it all the time unless it's like a really good book. So that's the way that I kind of thought about that. But I just love David's style so much. He really started to inspire me, much like I'm sure most of the world. I just want to say thank you for bringing so much joy to people and just doing crazy stuff all the time, being like a crazy good entertainer. You're making some serious change in people's lives, so really appreciate you for all that you do, even though we don't know each other at all. And yeah, thanks again for being a great person, spreading so much joy and positivity to people, especially in times like these when people really need it.